Hey, what's happening, y'all? It's your boy Rico from Street Scores. I'm gonna play some Taylor Heineke film. You already know Morgan Moses is the starting right tackle number 76, so you can watch him while I'm talking. But we have to talk about this. This actually is pretty big breaking news for us. Maybe not to the rest of the NFL, but apparently the Washington football team is likely moving on from the longtime starting right tackle Morgan Moses, sources say, giving Moses the ability to seek a trade. And it's so weird because, first of all, Morgan Moses, one of the most dependable players we've had. We already just lost Ryan Kerrigan to the Eagles. Now we're losing another guy that just doesn't miss games. That man, Morgan Moses, has started for us mostly at right tackle. He filled in at left tackle that one time. Everybody on the offensive line was decimated. And we had to start David Sharp at right tackle. I think it was a game or two last season. And if you can remember, he was like the only guy that was fully healthy that 2018 season when the entire roster was decimated. I mean, Chase Roulier was there most of the time, but even he missed a couple of games. Morgan Moses played through two leg injuries those seasons. But like I was saying, Morgan Moses is super dependable, man. Hasn't missed a start since 2015. I mean, 16 games all the way through, man. And it's just weird to give up somebody that dependable, especially since he's not even making that much money. I mean, because right now he's only due $7.75 million. He is a 9.965 cap hit, and for as good as he is, as dependable as he is, that's still a bargain. Like, that's really good value right there. And if you cut him this season, he's only a less than $2 million cap hit, so you save about $7 million. But, I mean, like, what are you trying to save $7 million for? If you trade him, of course you take on no dead cap. The other team takes on all of his salary. But, like, what are we trying to save money for? Like, are we trying to trade for, like, an Aaron Rodgers or something? Or is there another player we're trying to sign off a free agency or something like that? What are we clearing cap space for? Because it's not because of Morgan Moses isn't good. He's coming off of his best season, and it's not coincidental that it was also his healthiest season. He wasn't fighting through injuries because everybody else was hurt. Somebody else would get like a leg injury, they miss a few games. Morgan Moses get a leg injury, he's fighting through it. And even though he wasn't great while he was playing, he was hurt. That's why. And that's why last year when he was finally fully healthy, no leg injuries, he played arguably his best football since he's been here. And it's still weird to me that they're trying to save this money, like, for what? I mean, maybe you get like a late round draft pick for him, but is that worth it? I mean, somebody that's this dependable, you know that he's gonna start at right tackle for you every season for 16 games, most notably this season. And what this is telling me is that apparently Samuel COSMI, Charles Leno, Sadiq Charles, Cornelius Lucas, at least three of those four guys are ready to go. Like, they must know something that we don't. Apparently Charles Leno is ready to start at left tackle. Cornelius Lucas is ready to switch to right tackle and start. And then Samuel COSMI is further ahead in his development. Or maybe Sadiq Charles is ready to step in and play tackle rather than guard or something like that. I don't know, because as dependable as Morgan Moses is, and as big of a question marks we have on all of these guys, I think Cornelius Lucas is underrated and is a solid starter. But he couldn't even stay healthy for a full 16 games last season. Samuel COSMI is very raw, at least from what I've seen in college. And Charles Leno was a Pro Bowler in 2018. And then he had a bounce back season last season. But he's still not this just, we know he's going to hold it down and play at a very high level at left tackle. I mean, he's very dependable as well, like a Morgan Moses. He's played 93 consecutive games. So we know he can fill in and stay healthy. But it's not like I'm expecting Charles Leno to come in and be a certified Trent Williams type of guy. So I don't know. There's still so much mystery and confusion surrounding this offensive tackle situation. If you take away Morgan Moses, with Morgan Moses, I think it's one of the deepest positions. But when you take him away, is Cornelius Lucas health? Is Samuel COSMI, is he ready to even play yet? And Sadiq Charles, is health, and is he ready to play yet? So outside of Charles Leno, who's projected to probably start at left tackle, it's kind of an ugly situation. Again, it's a lot of depth, but it's not like we just have a whole bunch of guys ready to start right now, and that we know can start for a full 16-game season like a Morgan Moses can. And it's still so weird, too, because, like, why not keep him this year? And then if you want to, release him after this upcoming season, because he'll be $0 worth of dead cap after this season. You let him stay on for this season as a dependable guy. Let Samuel COSMI take his time developing. Sadiq Charles, the same thing. And then when in doubt, you release him after this upcoming season. And again, you take on no dead cap. But apparently they want to trade him right now. And what's even crazier is that not only are they allowing him to seek a trade, But they're also saying if they don't find a suitable trade partner, they may just release him before this season. And I'm just trying to figure out why they're so adamant about moving him, whether it be through trade or releasing him. I'm really confused about it. And again, like I said, he's coming off of his best season. Even Pro Football Focus agrees, because they gave him an 80.6 overall season. They graded his run block in 85.9 and his pass block in a 70.8. And they had him ranked as the sixth highest graded right tackle in the NFL. So I'm just really confused as to why we're moving on from him. He's easily a top 10 right tackle. And again, for the money that he's making, it's actually great value. So I'm just confused. It'd be one thing if he like had this huge contract and we were trying to make space. Or at least if we knew who we were making space for. Like, who are we creating salary cap space for? Why are we releasing Morgan Moses when we're currently under the cap right now and we're good? Like, what is this extra space that we need? Samuel COSMI did play quite a bit of right tackle in college. Cornelius Lucas also played quite a bit of right tackle when he played for the Bears before he came to us. So I'm assuming it's between one of those two that will start. More than likely, Cornelius Lucas day one, Samuel COSMI eventually as he takes over the starting spot. Maybe, I don't know. But again, it's still weird that they won't just wait to move on from Morgan Moses, whether it be through trade or release, after this season. Why are they in a rush? Again, who are they trying to get? He's our longest tenured player now with Ryan Kerrigan gone. And I know Ron Rivera is just trying to purge the entire roster, but don't get rid of the good ones. But at the end of the day, as always, in Ron Rivera, I trust, because every time I think that they're making a mistake, it ends up working out well for us in the end. So maybe this is another one of those situations, but this is still very weird to me. And I guess maybe because he's coming off of his best season of his career, they're going to try to sell him as high as possible. They may not want to risk it. And then they will probably end up selling him for less later. Like, maybe you can get a higher pick for him coming off of his career year than you can after this next season, even though I expect him to play very well next season as well. So I don't know. I'm really confused by the strategy of this. I'm just brainstorming, trying to figure out exactly what's going on. It's still very weird to me. I mean, the craziest part about this is the fact that they're not only allowing them to seek a trade, but if they can't find a suitable trade partner, they may just release them before this season. Like, that is crazy. Like, what is the rush to getting rid of a very dependable, gonna start for you 16 games, give you top 10 production at that position? If anybody knows, man, please get in the comment section and let me know how, like, where's the sense in this? What's the strategy? Does this say that Samuel COSMI is further ahead in his development than we think? Like, it has to be something. There's something to this that we're missing. Is this, again, like I speculated earlier, is this trying to create salary cap space to bring in a high paid player, like maybe like an Aaron Rodgers or something? I don't know. This is just a very strange situation, but please get in the comment section and let me know how you feel about everything going down, everything discussed in this video. As always, man, please like this video if you liked it. If you learned anything, please subscribe. If you haven't, hit the bell next to the subscription button so you get a notification every time I release an informative and opinionated video like this one. And as always, man, I appreciate all of the support always, man. Big shouts out to everybody that donates to the channel. Big shouts out to all of my sponsors, especially my Pro Bowl sponsors whose name you see scrolling on the screen right now, man. Really appreciate y'all. A special shouts out to my one All-Pro sponsor in Jaden. Man, I really appreciate y'all. I'll catch y'all later. Please get in the comment section, because, I mean, maybe y'all know something I don't. I don't know. But please get in the comment section. Let me know how y'all feel about everything. I'll catch y'all later. I'm out.